Warning, full spoilers for Black Panther, Wakanda Forever. With the release of Black Panther, Wakanda Forever, viewers meet Namor the Sub-Mariner, a key figure in Marvel Comics history, and a key player in the progress of the MCU. Of course, that's because he's a mutant with strong ties to the X-Men. We'll talk about what we've learned about mutants in the movie, how it can help introduce the X-Men to the MCU, and what Namor's role will be in the MCU going forward. What Wakanda Forever reveals about Namor and the mutants. We take an in-depth look at the origin story of how Namor obtained his original powers in Black Panther 2, and how his people came to live underwater, the Talokanil. While the movie only focuses on Namor during this sequence, there are some aspects that refer to a much larger design that could lead to the X-Men. Back in South America 1571, we learn that the people of Namor were suffering from wars and diseases brought by the Spanish conquerors, and therefore the shaman of the Namor people prayed for help to the Mayan god Chalk, and the god gave them the bright flower growing under a sea. The flower appears to have sprouted from a vibranium meteorite that fell into the ocean long ago, making it essentially an aquatic version of the heart-shaped plant, the mystical plant that gave Black Panther its powers. Namor's mother was pregnant and feared that the plant would harm her child, so they made her a bracelet symbolizing a promise that her new people would be their firstborn son's leader. After consuming the flower in a potion, the people of Namor fell into a deep sleep and woke up with a new water physiology. They went to the ocean and established the underwater kingdom of Talokan. It seems that Namor's mother took the potion while pregnant, and perhaps with the help of the god Chalk, she was born a mutant unlike the others. His most distinctive features were his pointed ears and ankle wings, not to mention his super strength and ability to breathe both underwater and on the surface. Marvel's Namor revealed, who's Sub-Mariner? 13 images. How Wakanda installs Forever X-Men. There are some key elements from Namor's origin that form the basis of the X-Men. Before this movie, it looked like X-Men would join the MCU via the multiverse. After all, Professor X of another universe has appeared in Doctor Strange in the Multiverse of Madness, and recently Ryan Reynolds announced that Deadpool 3 will include the return of Hugh Jackman's Wolverine alongside Deadpool, and fans have been watching every it assumes that both characters will jump out of the game. From the Fox X-Men universe to the MCU. However, Wakanda Forever offers another possibility. Maybe Marvel is working on a way to make mutants look more natural. Namor uses the term mutant to describe himself when telling his origin story, the term we all know well in modern Marvel society to describe anyone with an X gene. Namor's mother, who consumed the vibranium-infused plant while pregnant, may have been what created the X gene, literally giving birth to the mutant race. Namor's origins date back to the 1500s, so there will still be centuries for the X gene to spread before we catch up to the present day in the MCU. Ms. on Disney Plus in the Marvel series, we learn that Kamala Khan has a mutation of unknown origin, so perhaps the origin of her powers can be traced back hundreds of years to Namor. Namor was the first mutant in Marvel Comics publishing history, so it's fitting that he's the original mutant from the MCU. Exactly how the X gene spread from a hidden civilization under the sea to the surface world is a mystery. Perhaps Namor stepped into the surface world and passed on her unique mutant DNA, giving birth to a child. Maybe vibranium meteor sites in the world that affect other people in different ways, but since vibranium alone does not create a mutant, there must be a catalyst. It's hard to say which of these paths the MCU will take, if any, but Marvel has definitely done this to have some sort of in-universe origin story for the X-Men. Play loading. Namor's progressive role in X-Men and MCU. As for where Namor and the X-Men went from here, we have some theories based on the comics. While Namor and the Talokan people are still a secret civilization, it is only a matter of time before their existence is revealed to the rest of the world. After that, it wouldn't be a surprise to see Namor join the various bands that exist in the MCU. In the comics, Namor's first priority is always his home in Atlantis, and his brutal nature often tags him as an anti-hero, which is why he's been part of both hero and villain teams over the years. He started out as a member of the Hero Invaders and became a member of the X-Men, Illuminati, and Avengers, among others. Namor was one of the founding members of the Illuminati. However, Namor often makes choices that serve his own interests and those of his people, even at the expense of what the other heroes perceive as better, which is why he too has become a part of the Dark X-Men and evil. The version of the Illuminati known as the Cabal. The way Namor is portrayed in Wakanda Forever is an excellent display of the character's anti-hero nature and a taste of what to expect from him as the MCU continues. If and when the X-Men join the MCU, Namor will be a good fit for the team because if our theory is correct, they're all just one person under the mutant gene, so he'll feel a kinship with them. It wouldn't be a surprise if the Illuminati and or Avengers also join the MCU version. But don't be surprised to see him join up with the likes of Dr. Doom, and even the next Thanos as soon as the wind changes and he sees an opportunity for his people to gain power. Of all the characters introduced in Marvel's Phase 4, Namor is definitely a wild card to consider. Be sure to check out our other Black Panther, Wakanda Forever pieces, including the original plot of Black Panther 2 and our review of Black Panther, Wakanda Forever. And also check out if there's a Black Panther 2 post-credits scene.